guys, welcome back to my channel. Today we're doing one of my favorite types of videos to do, which is a foundation review.
Another one.
And today we're reviewing a type of foundation that I don't normally use, but I decided several months back when I purchased it that I needed to give it another try. Yes, another try. I did try it years ago and I hated it. And I decided that now was the time to actually give it another go. And I will let you know in my review exactly how I feel about it. And as you've already seen in the title, it is MAC's Face and Body Foundation. So let's get right into it. MAC's Face and Body Foundation is a very lightweight, water-based foundation. And as I mentioned in my intro, this is actually my second go around trying out this foundation. Years ago, I got a sample that I tried, and because my skincare routine was not on point, I was using a lot of products that were drying out all my oils, because that's all I wanted, that's all I cared about, was getting all the oil off of my oily skin. And because of that, this particular foundation looked horrible on me. I hated it, and I thought, no way is this foundation a good foundation for combo oily skins. I would never recommend it to anyone with oily skin, but now I would. I would actually recommend it for all skin types, including oily. And the reason for that is definitely because I have completely changed my skincare routine. I use much better products that cater to my skin type. And I really feel like that has made a huge difference, along with doing the necessary steps that someone with oilier skin needs to do to pull this type of foundation off in terms of prepping and setting your skin. So this is my bottle that I have here. I am in the shade C6 for reference. I am an NC4445, so C6 works the best for me in this foundation. You are actually getting quite a little bit more than standard. This is 50 mils or 1.7 fluid ounces. Now, just comparing this to my Lancome, just looking at the two bottles side by side, you would think I'm getting more product in Lancome, but I'm actually not. I'm getting more in this, which I really do appreciate. As far as the applicator goes, it is a squeeze type of a tube. No pump, you just squeeze it out of the top there, which I don't mind because it is such a very lightweight, water-based, as I said, foundation. And I hope you guys can hear that. Extremely, extremely liquidy. And I'm gonna insert some photos of just how liquidy and runny this foundation is. There are actually two sizes. I opted for the smaller one because I don't run through my foundations that quickly. So that size is suitable enough for me. That is 50 mils or 1.7 ounces. And that will run you $33 Canadian or 28 US. If you do want the bigger bottle, they have quite a large bottle at 120 mils or 4 fluid ounces. And that will run you 44 Canadian dollars or 38 US. So in comparison to many other higher end foundations on the market, that is actually not a bad price. So if you're counting your coins and you're wanting to save a little bit on makeup, definitely give Face and Body a try because it is such a wonderful foundation. It has a cult following, one of MAC's best-selling foundations, and it's not as expensive as other higher-end brands. So because of the consistency of this foundation, it is very sheer. You will not get a full coverage result with this foundation. It is absolutely a light to medium buildable type of foundation. And because of the lightweight consistency of it, it's also fantastic for mixing in with other foundations. If you are a full coverage girl, but there will always be times, of course, that you're just not feeling it. You're just not wanting to put on a full coverage foundation, especially in the hotter months of the year. You can still use that full coverage, but you can add in a little bit of face and body to sheer it out a little bit. So you can still get a good amount of coverage with the components of the full coverage foundation you're using, but have it sheared out just a little bit so it doesn't look so heavy on your skin. It is very lightweight, very moisturizing, very much of a long wear type of foundation. Even though it is lightweight and feels very comfortable on the skin and doesn't give the most full coverage, it does last all day long, which surprised me because, of course, I'm sure a lot of you guys assume that the more full coverage a foundation is, the longer it will keep you covered. But this foundation really does an excellent job of lasting all day. One of the biggest downfalls of this foundation is the shade range. Unfortunately, the shade range is really not good at all. In my size, the 50 mil 1.7 fluid ounces size, you have 13 shades to choose from. And that only gets worse if you go up to the larger size. The larger 120 mils or 4 fluid ounces size only has 11 shades to choose from. Don't ask me why, it is what it is. So if you're able to find your shade, please do give this foundation a try. But if not, I understand that many people will miss out on getting to try this unless you're okay with buying two to mix. There really is not a very good shade selection. Face and Body offers two undertones, N's and C's. N for neutral, C for cool. I am in the shade C6, so that means I am cool according to MAC. MAC does their undertone descriptions completely opposite from the rest of the makeup world, so their C's or NC's are actually the more yellow-based undertones, and the N's or NW's are actually the cooler undertones. So this, the C range is definitely for those of you who have a warmer, more yellow golden undertone, and the N's are going to be those that have a more pink or red or cool undertone. One other thing I do want to mention to you guys, there is a white shade. And when I say white, I mean pure white. So all of you very, very fair ladies and gentlemen out there that can never find a foundation light enough for you, definitely check out the white shade, because that would be a perfect mixer to include in your foundation collection. You can just pour in a couple of drops into any other foundation that you have to lighten it up a bit. So definitely check out the white shade in this brand. So as far as my personal experience goes using the product, I found it to be probably the best skin-like foundation I've ever used. MAC really did a fantastic job formulating this foundation to give you an okay amount of coverage. Once again, not full, so it will definitely be more suitable for people with near perfect type of skin that doesn't need a whole lot of coverage. It does a great job of just evening out your skin tone. So if you already have a great concealer, use that to spot conceal any areas that the foundation does not cover well, and you'll be good to go. Very skin-like, very natural. It just gives a beautiful wash of color over the skin, and it lasts all day, and it just looks beautiful in photos, in videography. You can't go wrong with this type of foundation if you are interested in your skin looking like skin. All the combo oily people out there who maybe have tried this foundation and, like me, swore up and down that it was not oily skin friendly, definitely give it a try again, and this time, make sure your prepping and setting steps are on point. Use a mattifying primer and a mattifying setting powder. For me, as a combo oily person, that's a must. I'm not gonna use this foundation without doing those two steps. I need to make sure that my skin is properly prepped and set so that I get the most skin-like benefits out of it and not so much the dewy luminosity properties that it does offer as well. So all of you with drier skins, this is definitely a wonderful foundation you can use without adding any of those steps. You can probably just slap this on and not even bother using a primer, maybe just a light dusting of translucent powder in your T-zone, and you're good to go. But definitely for the oilier skinned people out there, definitely make sure that you do a great prep beforehand and a very good set after, and you'll be good to go. So that's it, guys. That's my review on MAC's Face and Body Foundation. I am so happy that I gave this foundation a second chance. It has definitely become one of my most favorite foundations ever. And definitely the better my skin looks, the more I want to use it because it does give you such a beautiful, natural look. So please give me a thumbs up if you did enjoy this video, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.